respective lines. Nice. I just want your lower leg foot a little bit further back, okay? So it's a little bit more your ankle under your seat. That's it. Keep doing what you're doing, everyone. Good job. Let's go for a change of lane when you're ready. Change of direction. Now, we're changing direction. The biomechanics of your horse are changing. If you throw a ball with your right hand, you throw a ball with your left hand, they're both not going to match. We've got to really say to ourselves, when we're changing direction, what do I have to do in order to help the horse? And all about the horse being comfortable. Let's think about it. We are on the horse's back. This is a gift that we get to ride the horses. These horses don't have to do this. This is for our pleasure. So I want the horses to feel the best they can feel at all times. Sometimes the horse won't realize you're guiding them through a better place. And you've got to start to work through it a little bit differently. But I want your horses to be able to trust your hands, in that your hands and your leg and your seat is guiding you to a place that feels comfortable, rather than fighting it. Okay, we're going to do a little minute in the trot, then we're going to come back down for a little walk break. Really important walk breaks. Really, really important that the horse digests what you're talking about to the horse, and that he obviously gives his body a little break. When you're ready, you can all come back to the walk. Okay, let's see that horse is stretched out now. Free walk on me. Maximum ground cover. Good, love that stretch there. Good, Mackenzie. Super stretch here from Josie as well. You can even get, if you feel comfortable, bro, a little bit more length of rein. Think about just stretching out that touch more. Okay, so I was just playing to a little bit of biomechanics, just a minute ago. When you go from left to right, the biomechanics change in the horse. Your flexion might get stiffer, the slow might get shorter, the back might get tighter, the head might come up without you asking. Yeah, you might feel as if the same leg yield is different to another leg yield. Our job is to try and make the horses as symmetrical as possible, but let's think about being realistic. Nothing by nature is perfect. Our job is to try and make that perfect. That's the whole thing about dressage. We aim for perfection. But there's no score in dressage. What gives you a perfect score? We get off the 10 on excellence, it's not perfect. So if we can't aim, or let me say differently, we can't expect perfection. But our job is to always try and encourage the horse to be the best that they can be. Good walks going on here, much better than Mackenzie. I think you can have even a little bit more walk there, bro. Yeah, that's it. Now you've got some pride. Don't worry about that mistake you made. Keep pushing. It's okay. Swinging the seat. Good job. I think you get right back to that walk again. Yes. This is a common mistake what horses make. They trot. I think you've probably all been on the long diagonal coming for a free walk and you thought, I don't want to touch it because it's going to trot. We all get there. What I don't want to see though is that feeling of frozen. You know, we're getting double points in our free walk. If they do J-trot, yes, you're going to come down in the points. But if you're not pushing that walk on as much as you can be, you're also losing out on points. So at home, this is where we come into talking about the topic of what we're talking about. Riding at home to competing. When you're walking, feel like you can ask the horse to walk bigger. If he jigs, come back down, ask him to walk bigger. The mistake that we do is ask for a bigger walk, he jigs, and then we stop asking, and we say, we can't get it. He's got to understand that you're asking for that bigger walk. So ask again, every time he jigs, well, can't hold sit deep, long legs. Get back to that concept of getting a bigger walk. much better than a drum. So we're looking at activity, ground cover, fluidity. Okay, so we're going to have a little trot now and progress towards a canter. Now, be aware of each other. We don't want any crashes. I want everyone to be using their own space and keep an eye on each other. But when you're ready, I want you to start. You can either go from the warm to the canter or the trot to the canter, whatever you feel. So, I'm going to take a little look at your canters now. Really symmetrical in your body there, and Jody, think about your shoulders and your hips being in line with each other. Nice position there, bro. Keep your shoulders a little bit further back there, Mackenzie. Keep your legs a little touch longer. And a bit more of a stronger core. I want to see your core strong. The only way to get a stronger core is by practicing being stronger. If you're not one step thinking about what your muscles are doing with your, you know, this, you're not using your core. If you're letting this structure relax, this is not engaged, this is becoming loose, this is becoming not as steady, it's not a secure position. That's a much better core now. Good. And that's a gorgeous canter, nice. Still want you stronger in your core, Mackenzie. Much better grip, yeah. Good, so now we can start to see projection in our body once we start using our core because we're opening our diaphragm. Good, good. Well done. When you're ready, you can have a trot transition and a change of rhythm, but then it can't change the other way. Nice job. When you're coming down to the trot, this is your ticket for the thighs. When you're coming down to trot, open your thighs. If you're clenching your thighs, he's probably going to try a canter to walk. Because you want, in a canter to walk, you've got to come with an independent thigh, like a one, close, two, close. That's your half hop, that backs up your hand. But a constant thigh stops the water flowing through the body, stops the energy coming through. Take a minute on the circle there, Mackenzie, just to get him a little more through. I can see he's just a little bit up. So you take your time for the transition to canter. Nice big step here from Jody's horse. Good. I would love him a little more nose out if you can. Well done. Let's get your seats a little more on the silent rope. As you can see, Jody's got a nice secure seat in there. Good. I'd love your shoulders a little more rolled back. There. Thank you. Good. Look the best you can look on a horse. I want people to say, holy cow, she can ride. That's the way I would feel when people are watching me. Wow, he's good. You've got to put that extra 10% into looking good. Well done. Much better, Mackenzie. Well done. Love it. There, with Brock's horse. Nice position. That's what I want to see. Good. Okay. Back down to the trot. I'm looking at your transitions now. Okay, there's three transitions there. A couple were a little bit thrown into it, a couple were a little bit backed off. Keep the flow of the leg, half hop. It's the balance point. You've got to seem to go well, go well, go well. It's that feeling. Let's everyone go back to canter once more. Let's try and make those transitions a bit better, okay? I want you to know when you're going to trot. If you're thinking, all right, I'm going to trot, and then let him decide, that's not good training. You want to know when you're going to trot, because you're going to come up to a letter at one point, and you're going to need to do something at that letter. If you're just training to decide to do it on your own, that's going to backfire your test. All right, so eyes are on you now, Jody. Well done. Well done. Good. Better. Better. I've got a little stronger behind in that last step. A little bit more leg and just tuck them under. Let's have a little one more from you, Brooke. Lovely drop there. Nice swing.